For creation waits eagerly for the sons of God to be revealed. So who are the sons and daughters of God? It says in John chapter 1 that when we receive Jesus, when we believe in His name, He gives us the right to become children of God. In Galatians 4:7, it talks about that we are no longer slaves, but sons, and sons who are heirs. And what do we inherit? Well, as children of God, we inherit authority and power, and we walk in the identity of being dearly loved children of God. In Mark chapter 6, we get an example of what it looks like when someone walks in the authority of Jesus. He gives His authority to the disciples, and straight away they go out and they start casting out demons, healing the sick, raising the dead. They do all these amazing miracles in the name of Jesus. And later in that same chapter, more than 5,000 men and women all around Him, hungry, and they need food. And what happens is that Jesus prays, He gives the food to His disciples, and then it was through His disciples' hands, their hands, that the miracle of multiplication begins. As they give out the food, they actually just walk in obedience and trust with Jesus, and the multiplication of food occurs. And so this is what Jesus actually wants us to do today. Did you know that right now in heaven, He is actually praying for you at the right hand of the Father? It says in Hebrews that He is our high priest interceding for all of us today so that we can take on His authority and be His hands and feet into the world. It doesn't matter who you are, be it a doctor, a pastor, a teacher, or a mother, you have authority of Christ in you to be the solution to the crowd of people around you. God wants to make His kingdom known on the earth through you for the glory of Jesus. And side note, you can't do anything to earn your inheritance. An inheritance is given through love and relationship. It's relationship with Jesus that you inherit His power, being sealed with the Holy Spirit to do His signs on the earth. Oftentimes our pride can make it hard for us to accept that we are loved beyond what we can imagine. But it's not about us. It's not about what we deserve. It's not about what we do, but it's all about God. It's all about who He is, and it's all about how good He is. And it says that God is love and He is light, and in Him there is no darkness. And that God chooses you. He chooses to love you. And so we get to respond. We can respond in faith and believe and receive Jesus and inherit the kingdom as He says, or we can say no. But the choice is yours, and even all creation is waiting for you right now as the sons and daughters to be revealed, to be people who are loved by God and to walk out in authority to bring heaven to earth.